mind, then walk a mile to drink your water. You know I'm glad to let you, and above you there's no effort. We'll go walking out while by the sound of voice the sound. Anyway, we're going home in 3 days' time, so it'll all put itself right. That was a piece from 1969 from the stand-up album called Nothing Is Easy.
Yeah.
And before that, another piece from the same year, released as a single back then, called Living in the Past.
Yeah.
But enough of that old stuff. Let's do one of our more recent songs, something a little more up-to-date now from 1978. A song which features a very special guest who's come all the way from Reykjavik in Iceland. Well, not in person, but on the screen behind me. Her name is Una Birna. This is the title track from the album of 78 called Heavy Horses.
Yeah!
Patience. I may make you feel, but I can't make you think. Your sperms and the cuts hurt, your loves and the stink. So you write a word of details, and you make all your animal details, and you wise men don't know how to be. To be thin as a brick.
Help!
Right. Oh, and a sand cast for virtues are all swept away. In a tidal destruction in the moral melee. Clouds of flame, and the last quiver covers the newfangled way. But if you choose the word of the details, and your sons and the snappily feel, and your wise friend don't know how it feels. As a brick. And the love that I feel is so far away. I'm a pet dream that I just can't take a day. Draw the lace and black and hands and shout out the whole truth. Spin me down a long age, just let them sing the song. Yeah. the females and ship make all your animal deals and ship wise men tell now how it feels to pick Allison.
Expedition wandering through Hampstead Heath in the balmy summer of 1970, where all kinds of demented post-hippie people were lazing around and catching my attention. This is a piece called Mother Goose. As I did walk by Hampstead Fair, came upon my mother goose. So I turned her loose, she was screaming. And a foreign student's head to me, was it really true? There are elephants and lions too, they pick a dilly circus. What a mother made and come to try to catch some sun. Must have been 100 schoolgirls sobbing into handkerchiefs as one. I don't believe they knew I was a schoolboy. And a bearded lady's head to me, if you start your raving and you're misbehaving, you'll be sorry. And the chicken pants his came to play with his long red beard, and his sister's weird, she drives a lorry. By the putting green, I pop them in their overalls. For 20 laborers were laboring and digging up their gold holes. I don't believe in you, but I was hot on silver. Thank you. such honeys can't make his rounds. With this yet plan back, which you won't get back, started from a snowman. As I did walk my hands to take care, came upon Mother Goose, so I turned her loose. She was screaming,
back in the 17th century. This is a piece based on the fact that he discovered a rather interesting little tune that based on a courtly French dance form called the beret.
Yeah!
And then in 1969 I discovered J.S. Bach's version and turned it into a piece of really quite loathsome and disrespect-filled cocktail lounge jazz. So apologies to J.S. Bach, who might be deeply offended by this rendition. On the other hand, he might actually quite like it, being an improvising kind of guy. This is our version of Beret.
Thank you.
Or a t-shirt, but for a friend. Never admit to owning a Jethro Tull t-shirt. We'll see hopefully most of you in the second half for the rest of the best of Jethro Tull. The first one that comes from 1977, title track from the album of 40 years ago. This is called Songs from the Word.
Yeah!
Songs from the woods, poppies, red and roses, fill with summer rain, to heal the wound and still the pain, that threatens again and again, as you drag down every lover's lane, lies comes
Let me burn.
2-1.
Is it?
From 1969. Good year, 1969. Good number, 69. Yeah. Unless, of course, in my case, it's 69 and 3/4. Don't call me on August the 10th. Send me no emails, no texts. I'll be hiding under the bed until that momentous day is safely gone by. This is an opportunity to play the very oldest bit of music we're going to do all evening. It was written, not by me, of course, but by one of our most famous English kings, King Henry VIII. Now, King Henry was a bit of a nasty piece of work. You know, he was rather fond of whenever it took his fancy, he would cut the heads off one of his many wives when he tired of them. Well, as you do. In Texas. Now, this is a piece which shows the other side of King Henry, the kind of side that's actually the cultured, artistic chap that he also was. He wrote music, he wrote plays, words, poems, and this is a piece really credited to King Henry VIII, a piece that he wrote back then, and we're going to do our version of his, well, very aptly named in tonight's context. It's called Pastime with Good Company.
Thank you.
Last year we were on tour with a thing called the Jethro Tull, a rock opera, and a few new songs were written for that. This is one of them which touches upon the difficulty we have in coping with modern food production and the alternatives which are thrust in front of our noses. And I don't know about you, but I love to tuck in, maybe once, twice a week, to a big tub of MSG. Or maybe try some of that genetically modified soya bean. Oh, yummy! Yeah, it makes me nervous too, but we're going to have to get used to it as we approach 9 billion people on planet Earth in the next 40 years and have to figure out ways to feed them, us. So this is a piece. Hopefully we'll find a way to have some responsible, ethical food production. And this is the scary, contrary reality we might face. It's called Fruits of Frankenfield.
Yeah!
Woo! Oh, we were playing at London's famous Marquee Club, and I thought maybe I'd write a piece for our drummer. Clive Bunker was his name, and this is a little thing that was basically a vehicle for him to do an extended drum solo too. Back then, drummers used to play these long, enormous drum solos. They went on for hours, days, weeks sometimes. Happily, that's all behind us. Drummers don't do drum solos anymore. You cannot be serious. On pain of death, young Scott Hammond here will play just the teensiest, weensiest little drum breakout. We'd like to dedicate this to the memory of Clive Bunker. He's not dead yet.
But he could be.
In fact, he was feeling quite well last time I spoke to him. This one is called Dharma for One. Yeah. Scott Hammond on the drums.
Thank you.
locked him in his golden cage. From the grave, he is the God of
Yeah.
loud, my friend. The hardest part of playing is in.
You put on a song, you see it's only me.
Ah, you know it's only me.
Thank you.
Jethro Tull by Ian Anderson.